Blood cancers are killing significantly more Australians than previously thought, prompting the government to set up a task force to improve survival rates. The move's been described as a game changer that could one day mean blood cancer is a chronic condition, not a fatal one.
Valentine's Day last year, Brett Connolly was excitedly preparing for her first date with her now boyfriend when she got the shock news she had leukemia.
The nurse came in and started to cry and just said, "I'm so sorry." And I didn't know anything about blood cancer, let alone leukemia. I thought it was a disease that children got, and I thought it was a death sentence.
A new report's revealed startling underreporting of blood cancers in Australia, finding one person is diagnosed with the disease every 36 minutes and that 20 people die from it each day, placing blood cancers among the most common and deadly forms of cancer in the country.
If we do nothing about this, by 2035, we'll see almost 100 people diagnosed with a blood cancer. That's one every 15 minutes. And the number of people dying from blood cancers will more than double.
The findings prompted the government to establish a new expert task force charged with delivering an action plan to improve survival rates.
We'll, in particular, focus on early diagnosis, prevention and treatment.
The report identifies four key priorities to tackling blood cancer: empowering patients, accelerating research, reforming health services, and ensuring equality of access to care.
Melbourne-based Patrick Devine feels fortunate to have been treated for two rare blood cancers locally. He wants an end to the so-called postcode lottery of cancer care.
In the last 2 months, I've had 40 appointments. And for people in remote Australia, that's just not doable. And we have to change that.
Today, the Leukemia Foundation set a bold goal: zero lives lost to blood cancers by 2035. Philippa Carisbrook, SBS World News.